I'm relieved you're here, my friend. As dark as my fears may have been, they pale in comparison to the reality. If the shade of Naaman corrupts the heart of Valenwood, then the realm he calls the Shadowwood will soon consume this one. It won't be easy. The enchantments that once kept evil out are now corrupted. It's something similar to the blight we saw in Verant Morass, but much stronger. Every soldier who's entered has turned feral. Even you and I would not be immune. It's risky, but to defeat the darkness, we may have to embrace it first. The green is corrupted, and I think I can use my connection with it to thrust us into the realm of the Shadowwood. In that realm, I suspect we can get past the blight. Let's hope this works. All right, then. There, we're in Shadowwood again, as foul as it ever was. We should be able to bypass the Blight, though, and all the feral guardians that would block our way. Once we get in there, we need to head for the grotto. That's where the heart is. There's only one way to find out, isn't there? If we go feral, that's that. If not, I still suspect we'll encounter some resistance. The Shadowwood hasn't lacked for corrupted spirits elsewhere. And I can't imagine it will here either. Turn so many. We have to stop this. Get inside. The grotto will be on the other end of the bridge. Thank you. Formidable as you may be, I fear we couldn't get through here in the physical realm.
What is it?
Couldn't be that lucky. The shade has blocked the way. Let's see. These pedestals look as if they're still active. Yes, I know what to do. This is the entrance to the Valenheart. It seems the shade of Naaman has taken care to ensure his work is not disturbed. This is an ancient alien barrier. We'll need to activate the pedestals to pass. We'll need to get the keystones, Welkin stones, I imagine, and the Shade has likely scattered them throughout the branches of Hectorhaven. There is more, too. I will need to study these pedestals to decipher the way of unsealing the door. Good thinking. Whatever we can do to speed this up. In fact, as soon as you find each keystone, bring it here before searching for the others. That will help me puzzle this out more quickly.
I warn you, the Naemon you faced before was fettered by fear and mortality. I have no such limitations.
Welkin stones are the only way to break the barrier and enter the heart. The Welkin stones are the only way to break the barrier and enter the heart. I'll get you back in.
What is it?
Throwing your life for naught. The heart is already corrupted. There's nothing you can do about that now.
Well, Kinstone, let's get you back in.
And witness my wrath achieved. Then you will die.
Good. This should work. Hurry, we have to save the heart.
Once more to do her bidding. You just die!
Incredible. I've never seen such terrible power, but you didn't flinch. The shade is gone, but his corruption is not. Look at the heart. It's overflowing with corruption, spreading the darkness all over Valenwood. I don't know, but I have to try something. As I suggested before, perhaps the only way to defeat the darkness is to embrace it. I think I might be able to draw the corruption out of the heart and into myself. It'll be the end of me, I suppose. But the loss of one life to save the Valenwood. There's no choice in that. Ifri, guide me. I hope this works. It's working. Just a little more.
What happened to you?
This can't be right. It shouldn't have to end this way.
Intenir is dead? He is playing one of his Bosmer tricks. He must be. No. He really is dead. Dark Moons. Curse you, Indenir, for being mortal. And curse us for being so slow to arrive after we saw the corruption recede. Just like a Bosmer. It is not enough for him to save us all. He must mock us with the nobility of his sacrifice. We will feel this loss more deeply than most. But it looks like the dead prince is dead once again. Indeed, Queen Irene should be informed. She entrusted you with this mission, so it would be best if you told. Wait, did you feel that? Look, in the near!
Perhaps you should take a few steps back.
Saved him? Kariel?
The Valenwood brought him back. It's Ifrei's will.
What happened?
Indenir, Ifrei has chosen you. You're the Sylvanar.
Could it be true? Me? The Sylvanar? I fell down into death. And the Green reached out and picked me up and set me on my feet, and I was here again, alive. Incredible. Indescribable. Transformed. I have seen my making and my unmaking, and I am awestruck. I never imagined when the last Sylvanar died that I would be chosen. But if the people wish it of me, I will accept this role.
I'm going to go let Raz know. I'm sure he's pushed into the grotto by now with the Vinedusks.
Yes, and Queen Irene must be informed as well.
Come, I need to speak with Queen Irene. I expect she'll want to speak with you as well.
Is it true? What Kariel speaks? Indenir resurrected? Raz has had his eyes on other things, or he would not have missed it. And Neyman, Raz assumes he's dead. Again. Queen Irene has already decided to blame Peladil and the Heritans for this treachery. But Raz knows she loved her brother in her own high elf noble, emotionally stunted way. Tell her. But gently.
It's good to see Akuzri made it out safe and sound. Garesh Ri tried to warn him of the danger, but he doesn't always listen. He sometimes forgets he's a spiritual leader and not a hardened warrior.
Quite an amazing scene to witness. How did this one miss it? Talking to torch bugs, healing the forest, seeing invisible Spriggans. I thought he was just another mad Bosmer. Turns out, I was the mad one.
And Endaenir was the Sylvaner all along.
Besides a timely resurrection? A wedding, of course. He will be joined to the Green Lady, and together, they will represent Valenwood as leaders of the Dominion, with Queen Arryn and myself.
My soldiers stir from their feral state. I can only assume the corruption has receded and Naaman is again put to rest. It is well. The funeral rites and honors may proceed as originally planned. My brother was a pawn of the Veiled Heritance, you understand? The mistreatment of his royal body only makes their treason the worse. Now, what of the staff of Magnus? Thank you. I will see to its safeguarding personally. The Sylvanar. By the Eight. Main Akuzri, is this true? If so, that changes a great deal.
His spirit was gone from the mortal world. The Valenwood restored him.
Endaenir?
The Main speaks the truth, Queen Irene.
Kariel herself said Ifrei chose him. This one agrees.
Then rise, Endaenir. It is I who have the honor of bowing to you.
Queen Irene, please, I...
People of the Old Mary Dominion, I present to you your new Sylvanar. We won a necessary victory for the Dominion today, and we have you to thank. I'll see to the staff of Magnus's safety myself. As for you, the Bosmer have their Sylvanar. With both the Sylvanar and the Green Lady, it's time the two became one. Go to Velen Harbor in Malabal Tor, and we will make preparations. The Green Lady is in Malabal Tor, but rumors of attacks from Red Guards have reached us. It's imperative that the Green Lady be kept safe so that she and the Sylvanar may be joined. Velen Harbor, along the Broken Road. It's a quiet little town, perfect place for a wedding. Head there and inform the locals of the impending nuptials. I'll be along soon to bring the Green Lady her Sylvanar.
You wouldn't have liked it. The Mage's Guild is all dust and rules.
Comrade.
I'd love to get that sword at Beatrice Avani's store.
What's stopping you?
Can't afford
Davin's
it.
Davin's watch would have been overrun if you hadn't been there.
Take it from me.
I heard they don't live in towns, because the dark elf houses hate them.
Just between us, I heard the Ashlanders accuse the Tribunal gods of murder.
Thank you. Yeah.